I'm just thrilled we finally found the place. Well, nothing outside. Thank God. Okay, no one came in here with me. I think the door is right over here, so we don't have to explore the whole place. Yeah. Of course, who knows what lies on the other side. Fogwatch Laboratory. Made it. Come from the ritual site, guys. Just come from the ritual site. Nice. Okay, so it's down somewhere. I gotta summon you every time. They're down there. Oh, there's one up here. Eat my green lightning. Dead. Oh, there's that painting again. Let's see, would this even work? Probably not, because they're already ectoplasm. Oh, it did a little bit, I think, yeah. I think that completely healed me. Awesome. What you got? Can't interact with this stuff. I mean, I can't pick up the stuff. Oh man, this stuff looks so cool. What is this? Rune Dagger of Ambush. Poison of... Why do they put this stuff here and it's not real? I do not approve. Look at that. Books. We can't even look at them. Key to Fortress Fogwatch. You're about to go boom, aren't you? Time for boom time. Selena's Fists. Ooh. Lightning Rune rank 1. Another Poison of Woe. More books that don't exist in this reality. In this eventuality. Oh, yeah, I'll take that. Yeah, there he goes. Ow. Okay, I got water. Okay, so what's this way? Research papers. The unknown species of fungi propagated astoundingly swiftly in the buckets of Fortress Fogwatch. The trader wasn't sure if the spores even survived the long storage time, hence the cheap price. Now I planted a first colony in a corner protected by rocks in the nearby woods to study the growing cycle in the wild. Therefore, let's get to the actual research report. Frenas, 16th of departure. 8165 after starfall. Viewed externally, the mushrooms can be divided in a reddish to purple and a bluish to cyan type, which seem to be male and female characteristics. A thin stem bears the fruiting body, which is, depending on how many nutrients are present in the nearby ground, spread flat or tapered. In the later stage, the stem lignifies? I do not know that word. Lignifies to support the increasing weight of the fruiting body. The stem. I guess it gets thicker? The female shroomling with blue and cyan coloring can become vastly taller than a troll in the highest phase of its growth. It is amazing that the rather thin stems are this sturdy. In its mature form, elongated threads sprout out of the underside of the fruiting body, filled with lamellae, carrying the fungal spores within them. During maturity, they are trickled on top of smaller male mushrooms, which are often surrounding the bigger female mushroom and which are also discarding spores. From this combination arises a new mother shroom again. It is safe to assume that the wild or roaming animals will play a part in scattering the female and male spores in a large perimeter, which is why new colonies could rapidly spread in the wilderness. I have to keep an eye on it to prevent an uncontrollable proliferation. It appears as if the biggest part of the mushroom mass is on the surface. However, appearances are deceiving. A root-like mesh pervades through the ground. This is actually the true mushroom, as the excrescence that is piercing through the surface and growing upwards simply serves propagation. The brightly gleaming root mesh seems to be able to digest almost every living thing, be it animals, plants, or other mushrooms. Oh, jeez. So this is Fred S16. This is Mourndas, 20th of departure, 8165 after starfall. During my last walkabout around my plantation, arranged in the open environment, I could even note that a nearby tree was infested by the mushrooms. Parasitic, purple glowing veins moved from the roots across the bark up to the branches. It is truly eerie how far the mushroom roots must have grown underground. I will return in a few days to investigate how the different poisons with which I sprinkled the surrounding fertile soil have taken effect. Of course, I will also note the results of this plague. With the most potent poison, I should be able to destroy the remaining mushrooms with ease. Our employer, the noble woman from the house Dalminas, will be impressed. When I, as most able and courageous apothecary, successfully fought these extraordinary mushrooms. Turdas, 23rd of departure, 8165 after starfall. It is unbelievable. The most potent poisons that showed effect in the laboratory of Fogwatch seem to have absolutely no effect outside. Yeah, being your boasting, I figured it was going to go that way. On the opposite, my hidden mushroom plantation is now no longer hidden, but already visible from the wayside. Additional trees were infested as well. I'm such a fool. I have to immediately continue the research before my employer and the rest of my apothecary catch on to my practices. Oh, good luck. Sundas, 26th of departure, 8165. Who am I kidding? It was all in vain. My arrogance is costing me and my descendants everything. The mushrooms have developed into an unstoppable plague. My experiment has not yet been linked with the outbreak. However, I'm losing everything that is important to me. My son will not be able to follow my footsteps. I will flee with him so that he may not bear the blame of my failure in the future. I'm also losing my health. My body decomposes. I inhale the spores of these terrible mushrooms for far too long. Pharyngia Dalminas, my dearest love. Isn't that the one who... Dalminas. That's also the employee. Employer. Noblewoman from the house, Delminas. Unless it's another Delminas. The daughter, maybe? I will never be able to look in your eyes again. I created this disaster to impress you because I thought I could tame it. Thought I could be a hero, yet I was deluded. The mushrooms were vastly more powerful than I could have imagined. They pervade the earth, contaminate the water, pollute the air. Even the weather seems to bend down to it and protects them with a thick cloud layer against the sun, which was my last hope to dry them out. I'm sorry that we had to flee, my son. I'm sorry, Faringia, that my love to you made me blind. Blind to my failure. I'm sorry for every living being, which will fall victim to the infested part of the woods. I am so dreadfully sorry. So that's why this whole area is screwed up, because of him. Wow, thanks. Messes with my arcane fever and everything, although I didn't do that this time. Completed? Well, I'm supposed to find mushrooms around here, too. Salvage the mushroom samples from Fortress Fogwatch. Bank vault key for 2221. Sweet. Grave curse? So where are these samples? It's not telling me. I might have to walk around the whole place again. Mushroom sample. Oh, okay. 1 out of 4. Oh, it is pointing to me. It's empty, though. I guess it continually points to each one. I only noticed the arrow after. See, there's no arrow here. The arrow appears after we collect the thing. Well, that's interesting. What's this all about? Okay, so it's showing us the ones we already did, which is the opposite of how things usually work. Bring the samples and report to Balhazel in the Undercity, or deliver them to the apothecary in the Sun Temple as they are too dangerous. Huh. There's the exit up here. I know there's like two ways in here. I really don't feel like running through here again. This is the quicker way. Just double checking, nothing else around to grab? No, alright. Looking for ice claws and whatever else. Oh wait, there's another area through water if it... I don't know if I can get through here. No, not really. Alright, never mind. Can I... I guess from anywhere, right? Yeah. I was gonna run outside and do it, but don't have to do it that way. So I don't know. Should I turn to Balhazel? Let me just look at the quest notes again. So I was waiting for that. Oop. Apothecary responsible. His grandfather, oh. So his grandfather was the one who wrote those notes. Oh, he created the plague and then took on a job to get rid of it. The cure didn't work as a said make the Whisperwoods to what it is now. As Balhazel suspected. I think, he wants... I'm guessing he wants to make things right. So, not spread the plague further. Gonna hope I'm right and return it to him. The only problem is where in the Undercity. Undercity... Well, the apothecary... Or delivering them to the apothecary in the Sun Temple. Or the apothecary in the Undercity, I guess. Yeah, the other one. I think the apothecary is in the... barracks section? I'm not sure. Yeah. Try that. Maybe while I'm there, I'll buy some entropy books and sell some of this crap.
Not a good pipe of peace, Wade. Why is that stuff so expensive?
Well, this brings us back up to the top. I'm looking for the apothecary's section, house, whatever. What's this? Arena? No. Oh, wait. That's the silver cloud now. Yeah, I'm not going that way. It's probably showing me how to get back to the Sun Temple, and I'm not doing that one. I think it's in the marketplace, but it could be. See what this guy will buy off me. Hi.
Hmm? Well, yeah. Let me put it this way. Borrowed items? I'm not sure what you mean.
I mean, stuff like this. Oh, he doesn't have any money. He can't buy any of my stuff. He doesn't have any money. And he doesn't have anything. How lame.
Safe travels.
Yes, here. Apothecaries. I'm guessing this is where the guy's gonna be.
Hmm? Walk blessed.
Thank you. Sick person.
Please. There must be a solution to this.
Are you it? Walk blessed. More beds. We need more beds.
Oh, are you the one I need to talk to?
What? Who are you?
You're not it, aren't you?
What? Who are you?
Repetitive.
What? Who are you?
Okay then. Looking for Balhazel. Should I? Got in here. Oh my god, what? I am underwhelmed. Well, it's not worth it.
Please help.
I figured he'd be here, Balhazel. We've got two. We've got Sun Temple. I guess I should just go the way that they are showing me. There is an area off the tar pit that I owe this guy a rematch.
Move along.
I'm already past you.
Move along.
I'm already past you. I don't know what part of the undersea, so I'm just gonna keep following this arrow and hope I'm following the right arrow. I only see one. So buy entropy books another time. Let's see, maybe he's hanging out in here. Oh, actually, it looks like he is. I've never seen anyone hanging out in here, so I figured it wouldn't be the way.
Ah, there you are. Had any luck?
Yes, I have. You were right. Your grandfather really was responsible for this plague.
I feared as much. And why? Please, there has to be a reason. One that explains it all.
One that is. Your grandfather was a poor alchemist and wanted to impress that noble woman. He thought causing the plague and then curing it would win him her favor.
What? That? By the name of the sun, I can't believe it.
That's up to you.
What? What about the rest? Did you find any samples?
Yes, I did.
If there is any chance I can free the Hazels from the shame my grandfather caused, I have to take it. I can cure the plague. I just know it.
I hope so. I applaud your intentions, but experimenting with those mushrooms here in Ark is dangerous. Very dangerous.
Only if they were being handled by a fool, which I am not.
Prove it.
Please. I can imagine how this sounds to you, but I know what I am doing. If you don't give me the samples, there's no way I can atone.
Not sure why I should care, but fine, here are the samples. Find that cure.
Thank you. Thank you. This really means a lot to me. Here's your pay. And take this. You truly earned it. I'm in my laboratory now. There's much to do.
You are?
Walk blessed, my friend.
This is your laboratory?
Hmm?
Oh, we got a Pathicarius elixir and a blueprint and 150 coins. Well, completed.
Hmm?
Let's see if I can sell some stuff. I don't suppose there's any street thing from here, no. Well, that's cool. One more thing completed. The barracks is where you can buy those books, but I don't have that many pennies. I wanted to sell a bunch of stuff and come back. The only problem is it's late. Everyone's gonna be asleep. I don't know what's going on with the fence. He only has one gold ingot to buy, and he has no money. So I can't even buy something useful from him to give him money.
Relata Shirah, Leaper.
No one awake. Buy anything from me? Thanks. He doesn't respond at all. Close.
Hmm? Safe travels.
See, he's closed. Mattresses, like, put here. maybe I can sell that guy some stuff and then buy some entropy books. Maybe. If he's even there. He is here. Yay.
What is... What? Fair enough. Maybe there's a trick or two I could show you. But trust me, they don't come cheap.
Rabbit, don't come easy. Want some bell hammers? Rune dagger of ambush. Wow. Very cheap, actually. Carrying capacity, mana. That's white meat. Oh wow, you're running out. I have exactly 1500 coins. Oh, what are we up to with?
Yes, yes, yes.
I think am I on master with entropy? Entropy, entropy, entropy. Where is my entropy? I am on master.
Just move along.
I'm not moving along.
Fair enough. Maybe there's a trick or two I could show you.
I'm not moving along.
They don't come cheap.
Fair enough. Oh my god. Takes almost all my money. But now you have money, so I can sell you more stuff. Karex Charm, I don't want that. Increases mana by 12 points. This is better. Light magic spells. Shock resistance. Oh yeah, what does this do? This is what he gave us. Regenerates 40 health. For 4 seconds, cures all diseases, regenerates 20 mana for 2 seconds. Frost, magic, shock. I saw one of these. Rancid. I don't really use the rancid anymore. I wonder if I can use this in the arena. Sorry about that. Potion of Might. I have the amulet or whatever it is. Protection from fire. Have that spell, Soul Trap. I haven't used it. I do not have it. I have scrolls of it. But you can't learn from scrolls, you need a spell book. So I'm gonna hold on to the scrolls.
Well then. Fair enough. Maybe there's a trick or two I could show you, but trust me, they don't come cheap.
I've almost got enough for another entropy book. Okay, block I don't need. And heavy armor I don't need. Actually, I do have enough for an entropy book. It's like 990 or something. Werewolf recipes. These things, these books. Now I do. Okay, maybe some miscellaneous stuff, and that's it.
Fair enough. Maybe there's a trick or two I could show you.
He's running out of money.
They don't come cheap.
Okay, I'm gonna buy another book off of him. He can buy this stuff. Okay. That helps with my weight issue. And a tiny bit with my entropy issue. There we go. 77. Well, effectively it's... Oh, I always have trouble finding it. 85. I guess we could get to 110. Yes, I am Vatir incarnate. I'm gonna go sleep at the, what do you call it? The Golden Sickle. But I'll do that off screen, and then next episode we're going go for that meeting. With, what's his name? Aranthiel and friends. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always.
Yeah. It's not as if I didn't tell them that already.
Sick adventure. Go too easy on them.